Okay, right. Gonna make a Celtic plaque, or a design on a Celtic plaque. Sorry, on a plaque. This plaque is made out of plaster of Paris, and how to make this tile out of the plaster of Paris. You can see how to do that in the star sign video of the Scorpio star sign engraved into one of these plaques. Right, so first of all, I mean, you can do all sorts of these plaques and engrave whatever you like. I like Celtic designs. I downloaded this design from the internet, and what we're going to do is transfer this design onto the plaque and make a transfer from this printed design. And we'll transfer that into pencil under the design, and then we're going to engrave it with an electric engraver, like something like a Dremel or whatever you've got. And hopefully it'll turn out to be a nice little engraved design into the plaque. So first of all, I printed this out and got the size right in Adobe Photoshop. So that measures approximately 6 inches. So first of all, what we want to do how to make our transfer is to get a pencil which is quite soft. I've got a 5B pencil here, and what we'll do is we'll draw onto the back and cover the whole back with the graphite pencil all over, so this will sort of making up a makeshift carbon sheet, like those old carbon sheets you used to be able to get to transfer and copy writing or whatever onto another piece of paper or whatever you want to put it on. So once we've covered this back with the pencil, we'll turn it over. I'll cut it out, fix it to the plaster of Paris plaque, and then we'll just trace over the top of the design, and that will transfer onto the tile, so we know where we're going when we decide or when we start to do the actual engraving. Right, that's the back covered with graphite pencil. Now what we're going to do is use a pair of scissors and turn it over and cut the design out from a piece of paper. Okay, so there we have it. There's a design ready, and what we need to do now is place our design onto the plaque and straighten that up as best as you can. And I've got some sellotape here, so I'll stick it down just to give us so it doesn't move around too much. I'm just going to stick it on the top so that we can lift it up and see where we're going when we start drawing the shape onto the plaque. Right, so just tuck that underneath. Stuck on the newspaper there. And I do that. Just checking. Okay, so the plaque now has the design. I fixed the design to the plaque. Now what we want to do is get a harder pencil, maybe around sort of HB would be okay. What have I got here? I've got 2H, that's quite hard, so and relatively sharp. And now We could just trace over the design, and that should transfer onto the plaque. Right, so that's the image traced, and we'll have a look now to see if that's transferred, so which it has, which is good. So I can remove the transfer from the plaque. And what I'll do now is I'll just go over again just to make sure the lines are in place, as it's a bit faint. So I'll just go over just to strengthen up the lines. So there we are, we've got the design nicely drawn out onto the Plaster of Paris plaque, or traced out onto the plaque. And of course you can do any kind of design freehand or pick up some patterns from somewhere. Of course the design from the internet, or any design on the paper, of course is 2D, so what we're going to try and do here is make this 3D. So to engrave certain parts deeper and other parts to be more shallow to make this look like some kind of engraved whatever artifact or whatever. So get your electric engraver or whatever. I mean, you could do this by hand as well. Obviously it's quicker with the electronic engraver. So I'm going to use this small engraver, whatever you got, a Dremel. I've got a Dremel as well, which I might use to carve out the larger areas. But anyway, so we'll sketch it out first of all with the engraver and see where we're at. So here it goes. Ooh, switch on. Right, so we've got the basic shape engraved. I think that's picking up on the camera there. And now it's just a matter of just working, digging the grooves deeper and whatever, and try and make this look 3D. So I'll persevere with the engraver and see where we end up. We've got a screwdriver here also. I'll have to go and get some engraving tools, I think, but the screwdriver seems okay. So I'm going to chop some of this out with this screwdriver. Let's see where we're at. So kind of using a combination of the screwdriver and the engraving tools. Right, so I've etched in the main part of it. Well, we've missed a bit there. I'm going to go around the edges and carve that out deeper, so we're left with just the raised bit, and then we'll refine that towards the end. I'll just finish this bit off. Right, so that's where we're at the moment. So I've roughed in the deep parts. I'm going to go around that again and make it a little bit deeper, and then we'll start refining the actual shape on the top so I can see what I'm doing now, where I've carved out these deep parts. And it's just a matter of refining. I'll use a screwdriver to take these big areas out, and I'll try and find something else that's a bit bigger to make life a bit easier. I think what I'm going to do is, for the finished effect, I would quite like the hand carved look, so I'll probably leave that like that. So anyway, so we should continue carving out. There's a screwdriver here, so I'm going to use that to take chunks out and carve into these areas also. Right, so it's gone a bit deeper, it's a little bit smooth around the edges. I'm going to try and add a bit of definition to the actual design now and make these things look like they're interweaving, and see what happens. Right, okay, that's where we're at now. So we're getting a bit of definition there, and I'll just carry on refining it some more, and see where we end up again there. But it's taking shape, and I'd say it's almost done. So I'll just carry on refining. Right, so I'm going to use some sandpaper now, and tidy up some of the edges and whatever, maybe round some of the corners off just subtly, and I might engrave a little bit more and just see how it goes. Right, okay, there we are. I don't think I'm going to go any further than that. I'm going to leave it rustic looking. So I'm going to use that to mould. And then I can see the design now. I'm going to paint it up to give you an idea of what it looks, well, what it will look like when it is painted up. And come up with a painting style. So I'll show you that shortly. Right, so there it is painted up. I've done a kind of reddish brown, and then dry brushed it with some copper metallic effect paint. So that didn't come out too bad. So there, so that gives you an idea of what it can look like with one style of painting. So I'll get that ready for casting, and then cast a load up. Okay, bonjour, adios.